Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. For those of you who are first learning Photoshop, I'm going to show you a couple of quick tips that are often overlooked. And then later, I'll show you how to save an image without its background. The first tip will show you how to brighten dark areas of your photos without washing out their lighter areas. I'll make a copy of the photo so we can use the original to compare the results against. I'll press Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac to make the copy. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. The Shadows Highlights panel will open. By moving the amount sliders or entering values in the percentage boxes, you can lighten shadows and darken highlights independently of each other. Make sure the preview option is selected in the dialog box if you want the image to be updated as you make the adjustments. I rarely open the other options since my main concerns are to brighten the shadows and finesse the highlights. Placing the shadow slider at 0 reverts the image to its original state. As I slide the amounts back and forth, you can see how the shadows and the highlights are affected and do so independently of each other. Keep in mind, every photo has its unique characteristics, so the amounts you set for its shadows and highlights are specific to that photo. For this photo, I'll set the shadows and highlights both at 56%. Once you set the amounts, click OK or press Enter or Return. As I toggle back and forth, you can see how this feature enhances the details in both the shadows and highlights. For the next tip, if you have version CS5 or later, I'll show you how to quickly straighten an image in a photo that contains keystone distortion. If you're working on CS6 or later, open your Perspective Crop Tool. If you're working on CS5, open your Crop Tool and check the Perspective box. Drag a rectangle over the general area that you want to put into perspective and ultimately crop. Align each corner of the crop boundary with the corners of the image. When the corners of the Perspective Crop Tool are aligned to the corners of your image, simply click the arrow key at the top to instantly crop your image in perspective. I've been asked by many people how to save an image without its background, so I'll show you how to do it in this last tip. Let's say we want to save this logo without its background and without its soft outer glow and drop shadow. I'll open the effects and click off the eyeballs of the effects I don't want. Lastly, and most importantly, I'll hide the background. We should see just the image you want to save. Notice the background is a pattern of gray and white boxes, which indicates that it's empty. The next step is to trim our image, so go to Image and Trim. I'll trim it based on the top left pixel color, but frankly, I've found it doesn't matter which option you choose as long as the trim away corners are checked. Once you click OK or press Enter or Return, your image is cropped to its edges, thereby saving space and file size. To save it, go to File and Save As. Name the file and save it as a PNG, also known as a PNG file. Then click Save. When the PNG option window appears, I generally choose none for compression and none for interlace. For compression, older versions of Photoshop use smallest slow, but for recent versions, just click none. Interlacing makes download time seem shorter, but it also increases file size. Click OK to save it. If you open your PNG image, you'll see that it exists on a transparent background, and it'll retain any and all transparencies within your image. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.